You look good. I was wondering if you were going to still be hairless up top.
It was coming on for a while, and took it
down. Yeah, looking good, bud.
Yeah, you Thanks. Look good.
Should I follow suit?
No, you don't need to.
This is What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix is a joke radio.
So dominant on Netflix. Sandy Wexler, Hubie Halloween, Never Don't Give Up, The Crew, and now Home Team, which is a really funny movie. You're just all over the Netflix.
Yeah, I mean, it's the greatest place to be now, right? I mean, it really, there's no where else are you gonna go?
Especially in the last 2 years, no comedies have been going into the theaters. You know, the streamers are where it's at with the comedy.
The one thing I do miss is ducking into a theater to watch it with a you know, opening night with an audience. So
if I want
to do that now, I have to break into someone's house and just kind
of, it would be jarring,
stand in the kitchen kind of behind them watching.
But we need it. I'm so glad that you're making the comedies, because, you know, really? Every time Thanks, I Fortune. See any comedy movie on any anywhere, I'm like, thank you, because
it doesn't have to be good anymore. Just the fact that you're like, you're attempting to, it's not down.
I just love comedy so much.
This one's got a great balance because it's a real, based on a real story, and then of course there's some great comedy coming in, not only from yourself, of course, but Gary, your brother, he's got Gary. A good thing. And Rob Schneider's got
I know him from my Chelsea Lately days.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Can I ask a spoiler alert question?
Sure.
Was that Gary's real belly?
Yeah. Can you believe it? And let me say something. I love Gary. And every time we do something together, especially, you know, I like to abuse him in some way, like make him shave his head or do something. Like, I go, hey, man, you're going to do this thing, but you have to do this too. So this one was a push. It was a massive mustache, which was very funny at the time. But when you're in 140 degree humidity in New Orleans shooting, it gets less funny for the person wearing it. But yeah, his gut in this one, I couldn't believe. You know what? It was like the, you know, those coach shorts and the socks and the way they pull and the shirt, the tuck in, everything emphasized it. And it was just, it made me laugh. And him riding a bike and all that was just, it made me laugh. It looked like he looked like twins.
He did.
Scoreboard thing is tough, huh?
League don't want the boys to feel too bad about themselves.
I think it makes them feel worse.
Definitely doesn't feel great.
Hey, you did a nice job out there, Coach.
Thanks. We're getting there. Troy Lambert.
Hey, Troy, I'm Sean. Sean.
I know who you are. Connor's a fine young man.
Yeah, well, his mom did a great job.
That she did. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Okay.
Hey, Sean. How you doing? Mitch Bazan. I'm Connor's coach. Well, assistant coach, but still, you know, we're all part of the team. I hope I'm not out of line here, but I am really sorry about everything that's been going on with you. I mean, I've been seeing everything all over the news.
It's all good. Thank you.
Bounty Gate.
Yep. That's what they're calling it.
Yep. Newspapers, radio. Mm. It's online, too.
Yep, I know.
You know, the internet.
No, I know what the internet is. I do.
Yep. Bounty Gate. Yep. Everyone's talking about it.
Okay.
This was based on the real story of the New Orleans Saints.
He got suspended because of the Bounty Gate whole situation. And we kind of take off from there. I remember hearing about that back in the day. I don't remember anything about this, though. The story really takes place after, where it was the year that he was suspended, which is, you know, a crazy suspension. He couldn't have anything to do with the NFL for a year. Yeah. He ended up going home and reconnecting with his son. And he says, I'm going to continue to coach. I want to coach my son's football team, 12-year-old peewee football. And he took him to the championship. They had never won a game before. It was just such a great movie. He said it was the greatest coaching in his season in his life.
Aww.
Of football, you know, which I don't buy. I mean, he won the Super Bowl. Let's kids are great, but that's a close.
You don't get a ring.
Yeah, you don't get a ring.
The kids are great. And the kid who plays your son is a good
amazing
actor.
Tate is insane. I showed up that one day, and you think, it's a kid's movie. It was a scene. I think we started with like a pretty serious scene where I was talking with him and I was like, all right, this will be fun. Like Bad News Bears type, you know, we're going to have a good time. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He started acting and I was like, oh my gosh. Like I had to like really, he was throwing me. It was, he was like really good. He's
really,
he's amazing and annoying because I don't remember, like I didn't have talent at anything at that age. And these kids can kind of, you know, focus that talent. And they were good athletes as well. They had to be athletes because they had to look like they can play football and do all that. And they were a really fun bunch of kids.
Who was the guy who played the guy in the hotel?
Oh, that's Jared Sandler. That's Sandler's nephew.
No way.
It's his brother's kid. Yeah, he's a very funny guy. Very
really funny.
He's got such a unique, funny delivery. He made me laugh. Taylor Lautner is in it. Taylor's great. He was annoying to another athletic, very athletic.
Good looking, yeah.
You do like a backflip in the middle of a conversation. Like if things got boring, just to spice it up, he can just hit it.
And the whole thing was shot in New Orleans?
It was. It was shot, which it was challenging with COVID and all that. The biggest thing was the heat. I'm telling you. Yeah. We're all on turf fields, these high school fields. It was like 100 degrees out, but with the humidity, and the fields had to be like sprayed down with water. It doesn't keep them cool, though. What happens is the water ends up literally steaming. So it's like you're getting cooked. You're getting poached.
Yeah. Everybody's like having to drink Gatorade.
Yeah, it was a lot of that.
I shot something up here in Simi Valley. It was like 110, and they're just passing Gatorades around.
Crazy,
like,
right?
This is acting.
Yeah.
Who's having trouble with the playbook?
It looks unanimous.
Here. I don't want any space here. I don't see what's happening. People are getting through here. Salt shaker right there. That's going to be it. Okay. Now we got to get set up here. Now Connor, Jason, you guys are going to be our tortilla chips. That means Dennis and Marcos, you're our lime wedges. You're right here, which makes our hot sauce. That's Brian.
Brian's more of a napkin.
Now we're going green right formation. That's our initial formation. Y'all with me?
Yes.
Great. Okay. So now we have our X chips on the side here and our Z. We're the Z chip. What'd you do?
Farm.
All right, okay, here we go. We got our Z chip over here, but we're gonna send our Z chip in motion. So now we have both wide receivers on this side. Once they cross the line of scrimmage, they're cutting right, which means our hot sauce.
I drop back and fake it to the line.
Yes.
I'm the line. I pretend to get the ball and block.
Yeah.
And Jason and I cut to the right.
And then I throw it to the open tortilla chip.
Yes! Nice. There you go!
Are you going to go do some live stuff soon?
Yeah. I'm gearing up. Got some stand-up ready to go. Like I said, we're also jamming on another little movie we're working on. And
oh, nice.
That's it, man. Enjoying the kids. I did a play with my kids.
No way.
My kids had asked me to do a play. They say, you know, they are in a small community theater on Long Island. I said, I'll do it with you guys. I'd love to, you know, a small part. And it came up and I had to pay up, you know, it was like, you know, time to cash in. Oliver was the play and I joined up and I auditioned. I went in, I go, okay, I'm going to do it like everybody else. I got a part. I'm not kidding. There's so many shows. I said, I can't do this many shows. I could do, you know, I signed on for like five or six shows. Yeah. It's the hardest I've ever worked on anything in my career.
Why?
I got to tell you, because it's live. I had to sing a little bit and dance. Like the part I picked, I literally just wanted to push a broom across and go, hey, everybody, you know, it's involved. And it's, you know, you've got other people dependent on this, and it's a live audience. And it's not even like stand up where you can be, you know, if you mess up, you're not messing other people up. There's lines and timing and dance and steps and I'm getting older. So I'm just like, I feel like I'm forgetting everything. And I was getting pissed at my kids. I'm like, hey, you said you can help me rehearse. We don't have this. And they know they remembered everything. And I'm like,
oh my God,
please help me. We're opening tomorrow night. Can you help me? You know, and I got into a deep panic. It was a deep panic. And then finally, I'm not kidding. I was opening the playhouse. I was like, it was, you know, taking private lessons, getting people to come in there, help me dancing. And it was just, it was a lot of work. It was a lot of work. It was great though. It was a great show.
They must have loved it.
They did have a good time. It was so much fun. I loved it. I really did. And I got to say, talent, it means nothing. It's like these guys were good. Everybody was so good.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wow, I'm very fortunate to be where I am. I really am. It's like, because these guys are good.
To be a success, like talent's only a part of it.
Yes.
What does fortune lie?
Not the ocean, not Joe singing.
What does fortune lie?
Not a lake or berries.
Not a lake? I love a lake.
You don't like going in a lake.
I love a lake, though.
You like to look at a lake.
Yeah, but it didn't say in the song.
Let me write this down.
It's fine.
Update the lyrics, and I just say, going in a lake.
I love pontooning on a lake.
Pontooning?
Yeah, man. Put me on the pontoon.
I don't even know what pontooning is.
You don't know what a pontoon boat is?
No.
There's no way. Are you lying right now?
How?
Is that one of those dumb ones with the things on the bottom and a little canopy over the top?
Yeah, they're not dumb. They're the most fun, leisurely boat on a lake.
And everyone gets drunk on them?
Yeah, and you still scoot around and get to where you're going.
It's a great place to lose your virginity.
What? You lost virginity on a pontoon boat?
Yes, it was on Lake Altoona.
Altoona, is that the nickname for losing your virginity?
Yep, now it is.
Anyway, what does fortune like? Pontoons, baby!